life is like a free program in figure skating. Before a difficult element, you have to overcome the fear of falling, make an effort, and then get your breath back to be ready for the next challenge. I know it very well. I've spent 14 years on the ice, catching my breath most of the time. My family had nothing to do with this sport, but they asked me once if I'd like to do it, and I thought that it would be great to wear beautiful dresses and win medals every day. It turned out to be a different story, with months of learning difficult elements, with injuries and humiliation. I started progressing very fast. Learning new elements and doing them to the music was my passion. But most of all, I loved writing about it. I would make a whole novel about my every program. Today I'm a Chinese girl collecting tea leaves at daylight and dancing at night. Tomorrow I'm a Debussy muse, all gentle and tender. My mother told me that to become happy, a woman should be successful and independent, and that I should not waste my opportunity with skating. Very soon, I started competing at an international junior level. My diary changed. It became more of a motivation storybook about hedgehogs and foxes fighting for their survival. I was surviving too, suffering and surviving, fighting to become a happy woman in the future. Skating stopped being my passion and turned into painful torture with some pleasant moments of victory that brought me to a junior world championship. After the short program, I was leading, but then, right before my free program started, I got very scared. My fear made me lose to myself on the first place. I didn't want to accept it and blame my physical state. So I started training more and more. That exaggeration brought me to a serious injury. Media was pretty harsh on me as well, with all of the gossip that I will never recover. Well, I recovered and trained and competed for 4 more years to become a happy woman, of course. The moment I decided to quit was after winning the title at Swiss Nationals. Wait, I thought this medal would bring me happiness. But for some reasons, it was not like that. It was really hard to say to my parents that I want to stop my professional career, especially to my mom. How would she understand that? She lived my dreams, or maybe I lived hers. But then I remembered the fear that ruined my podium at Junior Worlds. So I decided that I won't let this feeling confuse me again. Very soon after quitting skating, I found my new handicap. I became a screenwriter. I'm 24, and I understand now that I don't need to be successful and independent to become a happy woman. I am a happy woman already, because I do what I love the most, and I'm not afraid to do what I need to become happy. But one thing I know for sure, fear is not going to be a part of it.
Thank you.